Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Utkarsh Kabra, radiologist at Getrill Polyclinic and Hospital, Jaipur. I hope you and your family are well and safe during these trying times. I'll be presenting a few interesting shoulder MRI cases today.
Starting with case number one, an MRI was performed for a 25-year-old male patient with history of recurrent shoulder dislocation. Let's take a look at the images. Coronal PD fat sat. Axial PD fat sat and sagittal PD fat sat. Axial PD fat sat image shows a compression fracture involving the posterior lateral aspect of head of humerus with surrounding marrowedema at the level of coracoid process, consistent with a Hill-Sachs lesion. Care should be taken to not call a Hill-Sachs lesion below the level of coracoid process as the humeral head normally flattens out below. This image shows tear of the anterior-inferior glenoid labrum. Adjacent periosteum is stripped, mildly lifted, and displaced anteromedially from the anterior aspects of glenoid, consistent with ALSA lesion or anterior labroligamentous periosteal sleeve avulsion. Coronal PD fat sat image shows a partial tear of glenoid attachment of inferior glenohumeral ligament involving the anterior band, consistent with agagal lesion or glenoid avulsion of glenohumeral ligament. In addition, a partial thickness articular surface tear of the anteriormost fibers of supraspinatus tendon is seen at the attachment site. To summarize, this case shows features of anterior glenohumeral instability with Hill-Sachs, ALSA and Gagel lesions. Moving on to the next case, before we see the images, let's take a look at the anatomy of the acromioclavicular joint and coracoclavicular ligament complex. The acromioclavicular joint is formed by the lateral aspect of clavicle and acromion process of scapula. It is surrounded by a joint capsule and superior and inferior acromioclavicular ligaments. The coracoclavicular ligament complex is the main stabilizer of AC joint and formed by the conoid ligament and trapezoid ligament marked as C and T respectively. A 65-year-old gentleman involved in a road traffic accident presented with history of pain. An MRI of the shoulder joint was asked. Now let us see the images. Coronal PD fat sat. Axial PD fat sat. Sagittal T1. The coronal PD fat sat image shows acromioclavicular joint dislocation with complete tear of superior and inferior acromioclavicular ligaments and superior displacement of clavicle relative to acromion. Sagittal T1 image shows bone fragments at the anterior superior aspects of the coracoid process. The normal coracoclavicular ligament complex is not visualized. These coronal PD fat sat images show a complete tear of clavicular attachment of trapezoid ligament. The remaining visualized ligament appears lax. Interstitial tears of conoid ligament are seen. Bone fragments are seen at the anterior superior aspects of coracoid process. These findings are consistent with coracoid avulsion of coracoclavicular ligament complex. Interstitial tears of trapezius and deltoid muscles are also seen. An incidental well-defined lesion is seen in spine of scapula with punctate hypointensities within, likely representing a chondroid lesion, possibly an enchondroma. Fracture of right third rib is also seen. To summarize, there is type 3 injury of acromioclavicular joint with coracoid avulsion of coracoclavicular ligament complex. Coming to the last case, 30-year-old male patient, a known case of ankylosing spondylitis, presented with history of shoulder pain, and an MRI of shoulder joint was performed. Let's take a look at the imaging findings. Coronal PDFS. Axial PD fat sat images. Sagittal T1. And sagittal PD fat sat images. Axial PD fat sat images show a shallow appearing glenoid which does not closely follow the humeral head, with a posterior labral tear indicated by the arrow. A cystic lesion is seen in the spinoglenoid notch, causing scalloping of the adjacent glenoid bone. There is posterior subluxation of the humeral head. Sagittal PD fat sat images show posterior labral tear as indicated by the arrow, spinoglenoid notch cyst, and edema within the infraspinatus muscle, which is likely due to compression of the suprascapular nerve within the spinoglenoid notch. Sagittal PD fat sat image shows marrow edema involving the posterior aspects of acromion process along the site of origin of deltoid muscle. Sagittal T1 image shows subtle flattening and sclerosis involving the superior aspect of humeral head and osteophytes along the humeral head. So, to summarize, there is shallow glenoid which does not closely follow the humeral head, with posterior labral tear and posterior subluxation of head of humerus, consistent with glenoid dysplasia and atraumatic posterior instability, as there was no history of trauma. Spinoglenoid notch cyst causing scalloping of the posterior aspects of glenoid bone and resulting in edema in infraspinatus muscle, likely due to compression of suprascapular nerve. This is likely a paralabral cyst secondary to posterior labral tear. Enthesiopathic changes with marrow edema involving posterior aspects of acromion process along the site of origin of deltoid muscle. This has been described as a very specific sign for ankylosing spondylitis. Secondary osteoarthritic changes likely due to glenoid dysplasia and chronic atraumatic posterior instability.
Thank you for listening. Stay healthy, stay safe. If you like our videos, like, comment, share, and subscribe to our channel.